Hello and welcome to the Vanguard of Light. We're talking about why manifesting doesn't work for me. This is part three, and we're going to be talking about Alex, which was in the first two videos in his story. So we jump forward. Now, Alex really got connected to pandas, right? He finally, you know, sorted out what in video one, what happened with pandas and alligators, and then he got video two and got some unconscious alignment, you know, about pandas. And so he really wanted pandas, right? And he's just thinking like, oh, I'm gonna pet pandas and pandas are amazing. And panda. He's always thinking about pandas, right? And he's telling his parents, oh, I'm gonna get a panda. I love pandas, I'm 100 pandas. Pandas are the best, they're awesome, they're amazing. Pandas, me and pandas, right? And that goes on for like, you know, about another year. He's getting older and older, and it's just all about his pandas. He's gonna have pandas, he's gonna go pandas. And his parents would be like, oh, what do you like about pandas? Oh, I just love pandas, just pandas is great. And they're like, oh, what new have you found out about pandas? And he's like, oh, I just love them. I want them, right? And it was kind of weird, because in the first video, because he spent so much time learning about alligators, right? For whole years, going to the zoo, learning everything about alligators. But his parents noticed that, like, he doesn't really know much about pandas. I mean, he's seen them a couple times. He's pet a baby panda, but doesn't seem like he's really doesn't know much about them. Like, he doesn't know about their habitat, what they eat, but he's like so obsessed about these pandas, but doesn't really know anything about them, right? And he's also kind of like been a year, he's kind of wondering like, man, why am I not getting a panda? Like, what's wrong here? Why are pandas not showing up? Well, you know, I want a panda, I should be able to get a panda, I want to manifest a panda, bring me a panda, why don't I have a panda? But he's also getting frustrated, like, why, you know, what's the deal? You know, before I saw all those alligators, thought on pandas and stuff like that, but why do I not have a panda right now? Right, and then his parents were kind of like, you need to like learn about pandas a little bit more. He's like, no, I'm just gonna have pandas. I want pandas, right? And then he's like, well, maybe I'll do a little research, look up a little bit about pandas. And he finds out that pandas are really expensive. Like, if you were gonna own a panda, like, one, you can't own them. You gotta rent them from the Chinese government, if I've got that right. And like, you don't own them. And it's like, they're extremely expensive. It's like, whoa, he didn't know any of that, right? He was just like, oh, I'm just gonna have a panda. And that's likened to what a lot of people do with like manifesting and why it goes wrong. It's kind of like the hope and pray, like a lottery method of like, oh, like the panda is gonna show up. Like, he's just expecting the panda is just gonna walk into the house. Like, it's just gonna walk into the house and all of a sudden he's gonna have a panda and it'll just show up, as opposed to like faith in action. Like, start taking steps forward to getting a panda. Which the first part would actually been learning about it, like finding out of like, oh wow, like, because in his mind he's just like, oh, I'm gonna have a panda, like even almost as simple as I'll go to the shelter, you know, get a pet panda. But when he found out of like, oh whoa, there's way more to a panda than like picking up a cat or a dog. But even if you're gonna get a cat and dog, you want to learn how to take care of a cat and dog, what's involved with all that. And that's a faith in action. That's the part of the manifesting of like, what would it be like for me to actually have this thing that I want, and start building that map of like, what would it take and what's all involved. First, like, just hope and pray. And like this, you know, I think it's like something extremely expensive, like $250,000 or $1 million just for the license to have the panda per year, let alone like actually being able to take care of it and all the stuff that'd be involved in that. But that was something young little Alex, older now, didn't know anything about. Because it was just kind of like the hope and pray of like, oh, it's just going to show up, without having some faith of like, oh yeah, I'm going for this. But let me also find out what this actually is. So that is the number third thing that could happen when like why manifesting goes wrong is not having that action, not having that faith of like, I'm going to have faith and take action, as opposed to I'm going to hope and pray it shows up. So if you want to get yourself aligned with, you know, being able to take, you know, action, having faith, check my course, Freedom Through Safety, because it uses your unconscious mind to remove unconscious blocks, which then allow you to have faith to move forward and actually start progressing forward to getting your goals, the things that you really want to manifest, not to mention finding out the real you. Because a lot of times our goals are based on limitations and we lose our spiritual power, because it's like, if you saw a kid running with scissors, you wouldn't give him a second pair of scissors and teach him how to sprint. You'd be like, whoa, let's not do the scissors. And that's kind of what we're attached to. We're like, we got these goals to kind of counter a hole, a wound, right? Something that's broken. And Source, Universe, God doesn't want to be like us carrying forward this broken with a Band-Aid. So it doesn't give us a lot of these things that we want to manifest, which would be more of a Band-Aid, while we still feel hollow inside. Source is trying to direct you. He's like, no, let's fill that hole. Because you're not supposed to have a hole. You're a child of light, right? So that's part of it. Like, that's why, but with, when faith in action, kind of like Alex, when he found out, I'm like, oh, 100 or 250,000 million dollars for a panda. Oh, I didn't know. Oh, now it makes sense why I wasn't just magically showing up, and more that was involved of like, oh wow, there's a lot more involved to having a panda than it just, you know, showing up one day. So hopefully that helps with number three on why manifesting is not working for you. And until we talk again, have a blessed day or a blessed night.